here on behalf of HotDJGear.com with a review and an overview of the Numark Mix Track Pro. Let's get started. I'm going to start off with the things that are included with the Numark Mix Track Pro. First of all, there's a USB cable which is used to power and connect the controller to your computer. Next, you get the limited edition of Virtual DJ, which is the software that you'll be using to mix scratch and so on. And of course, you get the quick start guide, safety and warranty information, and list of procedures that need to be done before connecting the Mix Track Pro to your computer. Now I'm going to start talking about the controller itself. When you first get the Numark Mix Track Pro, you'll notice that it's made mostly of plastic, which makes this unit very light. But being as light as it is, it still feels sturdy and durable. Now let's talk about some of the features on the Numark Mix Track Pro. On the front panel of the Mix Track Pro, there's a 1/4-inch output for your headphones, a 1/4-inch input for your mic, and a knob that controls the volume of your mic. On the back panel, there's a plug-in for your USB, and there are two RCA output channels. The first output is for your main speakers, and the second output connects to your Q channel, which I'll be talking about later in the video. The Mix Track Pro is completely symmetrical, so whatever I explain on one side, it's going to be exactly the same on the other side. So let's start below the jog wheels. There are four buttons below the jog wheels. The stutter button. The stutter button is used to play the track from the last pause point. The play and pause button is obviously to play and pause the track. The cue button. When the track is playing, you press the cue button to return to the last cue point. When the track is not playing, you can press the cue button to set a cue point. You can also hold down the cue button to temporarily hear that cue point. When you let it go, it will return to the beginning of the cue point. The sync button. The sync button is to sync the BPM or beats per minute to the opposite deck. Above your jog wheels, you have your cue points, your effects section, and your looping section. You can set up to 3 cue points for every track, which you will be able to return to at any time. For example, if you want to delete your hot cue points, you simply press the delete button. When the light is flashing, you select which cue points you want to delete. When you're done, you hit the delete button again. Now for the effects section. This knob here is to pick between your 7 different effects. These two knobs are used to control the strength of the effects. And this button here is to turn the effects on and off. When the light is on, the effect is on. When it is off, the effect is off. There are two ways to use your looping section. When the light is on, this means that it is in manual mode. So you'll simply have to pick an endpoint and an outpoint of your loop. For example, if you press the in button while the track is looping, it will return to the beginning of the loop. If you press the out button while the track is looping, it will exit the loop. If you press the reloop button while the track is looping, it will also exit the loop. But if the track is not looping, you can press the reloop button to go back to your previous loop point. The second way to use your looping section is in auto loop mode. To get there, you need to press the manual button. When the light is flashing, you are in auto loop mode. In auto loop mode, the in button is to half the size of your loop. The reloop button is to double the size of your loop. And the out button is to pick the point at which you want to loop or to exit your loop. For example, on the top corners of your Numark Mix Track Pro, you'll find the pitch bend buttons and the pitch fader. The pitch bend buttons can be used to nudge your tracks back or forward. The pitch fader is associated with the key lock button, which is right there. If the key lock button is off and you slow down, or speed up your track, the tempo will change and the key will change. But if the key lock button is on and you slow down your track or you speed up your track, the key will stay the same. If your pitch is at zero, the light will light up. In the middle of the controller, you find the mixer section. On the outsides are the treble, mids, and bass for each of the decks. In the middle, you'll find your cue gain, which is to control the volume of your headphones and or monitors. The cue mix knob is to control what is being heard through your headphones and or monitors. If it's turned all the way to the left, you will hear the track that you're trying to cue up. If it's turned all the way to the right, you will hear the track that is being played through the main speakers. You can use this knob to navigate around your computer through your folders and files. To pick a folder, you click down on the knob. Then you'll be able to scroll through the contents within the folder. You can go back into your folders by clicking the back button. Or you can load the track into deck A or into deck B. These two buttons control which track is being heard through the monitors and or headphones. Here you have the volume for deck A, deck B, and the master volume. And on the bottom there's a crossfader to fade between deck A and deck B. The jog wheels on the Numark Mix Track Pro are fairly large. They measure about 5.5 to 6.5 inches in diameter. They are also touch sensitive. So if you touch the top of the platter while the scratch light is on, you could do some simple scratches, or you could use it to navigate through the tracks. You could also touch the sides to nudge the track forward or back. When the scratch button is on, the track will stop when you touch the top of the platter. If the scratch button is off, you could use the platter to nudge. So overall, the Numark Mix Track Pro is the perfect product to begin DJing. Everything you need comes right in the box. Setting it up is as easy as unboxing it, and learning how to use it is even easier. For more equipment reviews, DJ interviews, and DJ tutorials, visit hotdjgear.com. I'm DJ Kanaka Pinoy, thanks for watching.